Welcome to this demo of Kubecost Collections. Kubecost Collections helps teams create single, deduplicated reports containing both their Kubernetes and cloud costs. Let's dive in and see how this works. Simply click on your new collections page, and then we can click Create a New Collection. In this demo, we'll create a collection called Infrastructure Team, where we can add all of our costs related to our infrastructure team. We'll also set the category here to be team, since this collection represents a team. You click Save. And then we can go about adding costs to this collection, which are associated with our infrastructure team. So to start, maybe I'll add my Kubernetes costs, where namespace is infra-kubecost. Click Add. And then maybe I want to add my cloud costs, where let's use custom label here, and then we can look at maybe our production environment, or development environment, rather. So we can add all the cloud costs associated with our development environment as well. Click Add All. And you can see that these costs are now added to our collection, both the Kubernetes and the cloud costs, and you can see how these costs trend over time. Now, what happens if I were to add all of my cloud costs associated with the compute engine service from GCP? I click Add. And what you'll notice is that when we add all these costs, we actually introduced this notion of overlap. So you'll see we have subtracted $10.50 from the total. And this $10.50 represents compute resources, which are overlapping between the Kubernetes infra kubecost namespace and the compute engine service from GCP. So we deduct this cost to prevent double counting any costs. So you can see here, now I have a report of all my costs associated with the infrastructure team. And I can look at this report, and I can also look at costs not yet associated with this team. You're also able to aggregate and look at your costs at the category level. So here, if we drill in, here are the costs associated with all of my teams, from my infrastructure team to my data science front-end or integrations team. And again, here you can see we're deducting the overlap between these teams. Additionally, many teams use collections to run chargeback or showback use cases. You're actually able to look at the costs here that haven't been allocated to any team. So if you were trying to make sure that all of your costs are charged back or shown back to some team, you're able to explore kind of the negative space and ensure that all of your costs are being allocated to a team. So this is a little bit about Kubecost Collections. If you're interested in learning more, please feel free to reach out to us at team@kubecost.com.